feel like I'm home. Well, I am home.
You are home. This is home. So local for you. You grew up in Howard Beach. Okay. Yeah. Would you make it out to Long Island a lot or not really?
I went to school in Levittown, Long Island. Yeah, I went to cosmetology school out there. Yeah.
Well, we heard you were a makeup artist before pre-American Idol. Uh-huh. So we do want to discuss that. Okay. But first of all, we're just so happy to have you here.
I'm happy to be here.
And you know the outpouring was ridiculous, especially on Long Island. We did not get calls about American Idol all season, except for when you got eliminated.
You were it.
Really? People looked at you as the hometown girl from Long Island. I know you're from Howard Beach, but still. So, people were
My whole family's out on the island.
Oh, really?
I have Huntington, Dix Hills, Merrick, Belmore, every place.
Is there a place on Long Island that you would come to and go to dinner or some place that you love? Where did you love to go on Long Island?
Okay, the Miracle Mile.
Oh, yeah, Freeport.
I would go to Toku, and I would go to Cipollini's. Those are my two favorite restaurants in Manhattan, out on the island.
There has never been anybody in the history of the show that has had a career after being eliminated that early on. What did you think was going to happen?
Honestly, I was so scared that night. Like, I was terrified. I was like, you know, I'm finishing ninth, and I don't know what's going to happen. I'm probably just going to have to go back home and sing with my band, who I love. But I, you know, that wasn't really what...
Right.
I wanted to go further. I wanted to perform another week or a few weeks on American Idol. And I was just scared. I didn't think anybody was going to want to, like, work with me. And then overnight, I kind of got this, like, so much support. I had 30,000 more Twitter followers overnight. And, you know, I never realized that people were really... You know, so supportive.
You probably weren't aware of the rumors.
No. It's like jury duty, but singing.
And you try not to, like, honestly, they open social media up to us this year, but you really try to stay off of, you know, all the blogs.
Right.
And you have to go on Twitter, and I love Twitter and Facebook and all that stuff, but it's hard because people want to bring you down. And you just really have to stay positive. I try not, especially while I was on the show, I tried not to feed into any of that, read any of it.
Okay.
I just wanted to stay in the best mind frame possible.
It was a major upset when you got kicked off. People were comparing it to, like, Chris Daughtry getting the boot and whatever. Were people telling you this, family members, like... People are going crazy. Or did you know instantly when you got booted off?
Well, what happened was, I remember I woke up at, like, well, I didn't go to sleep, so I stayed up all night. I started press at, like, 3 in the morning, and then I came back, and my parents luckily were there, and they turned on the TV, and, like, every single station was, like, my face was on the news, and I was like, oh, my God, I cannot believe this. Like, I really could not get over the fact that everybody was, like, so upset about the elimination, and it was really, that helped me through that whole situation.
Oh, right, what was that feeling like when they're like, yo, Tom Hanks got your back?
I could Ellen's not got believe your back. That Tom Hanks tweeted me. Ashton Kutcher, too, was so cool.
When you got into the top tier of American Idols, did you have an idea in mind, like, how far you wanted to make it? Of course you wanted to win, but was there a number you were really aiming for? Like, I hope I at least get this far.
I think what I would always say is, I hope I at least make the tour. Like, I hope I was, and I have, and, you always say, I was like, top 24, I hope I at least make that. And then it goes, top 13. Right. Well, I really hope I make that. And then I was like, tour, I'll be happy.
Well, and you've made the tour, and now you're back home. So what is it like to be back home and know that you're performing in front of all of these people that knew you before all of this happened for you?
Honestly, I have a case of the butterflies today, because I know that all my friends and family, people that I haven't seen in years, are going to be there at the show tonight. And I was singing Empire State of Mind, and I sang Empress State of Mind in Atlantic City when my family was there. Mm-hmm. I was getting emotional, and that wasn't even really my hometown. It wasn't, but it was close enough. And it's just, I don't know. I'm like, I cannot wait to get on stage tonight and just perform, sing my heart out for all the people that have seen me, watched me grow.
Right.
And have followed my career since I was a little girl.
Is there anybody that you hope doesn't go to the show? Anybody that you wouldn't want to be there?
I've maintained some wonderful relationships with a lot of people that I've met in the past, but I don't know. I mean, there's always, like, those people that claim that they know you, and I've had a few of those, but you know what? They're supportive, and...
Okay, well, that's at least good.
Yeah, you gotta just look at it like they're supporting your career, and without them and... I wouldn't be.
It almost, I don't know what the feeling was being on stage at American Idol, but being live in front of the people you know, does that make you feel more nervous or?
I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm really pumped. Like, this show, American Idol, was so different. Like, it was so much pressure. It was wonderful, but it was a lot of pressure being judged after every single song. And the tour is kind of, you just go out there, you do your thing. It's exciting. And the fans are amazing. But, you know, tonight is going to be a different story. All my friends are going to be there, so it's going to be cool, though.
We also were reading that you were a makeup artist before your big singing career and everything. Yeah. So, well, I love talking about makeup. So what's your brand of choice?
My brand of choice, I have a few. It's MAC, Bobbi Brown, Bare Essentials, Urban Decay. Now I have
Sephora is heaven to you.
Sephora, yeah. Absolutely. Oh my gosh. And also Bobbi Brown's amazing. I have this shimmer brick that gives you this glow. Like, you don't have to go for a tan. It just
What is it? It's in the shape of a
It's a little compact, like a square little compact.
Yeah.
And they have it in a bunch of, like a bronze, like a, you could use it as eyeshadow, you could use it as blush. It's like for everything. It covers all different things. So, awesome. And it gives you that glow.
If you had one thing that you wouldn't want to leave the house without, besides the shimmer brick, because I'm eyeliner and lip gloss. Cannot leave the house without either.
And I'm more of a foundation and lip gloss.
Oh, foundation.
Yeah, as long as my I like my face to look like, I feel like you need a good foundation before you leave the house.
Well, you look flawless. So here's another question I have about your tips. Are you a serum or a moisturizer before foundation person?
I always moisturize. Like the second I get out of the shower, I'm always like a bunch of times, because I like to keep my skin soft.
Yeah.
Otherwise, makeup doesn't go on as nice, you know?
And what's your moisturizer of choice?
My moisturizer of choice. That is a good question. I actually just use whatever I have at the moment. Aveeno. I have Aveeno,
Positively Radiant.
Yeah,
that's what I use also. Aveeno,
oh my gosh,
Positively
yeah,
Radiant.
That's what I have. It has that little
It has light diffusers in it.
Yeah.
So it gives you that glow that you're going for. This is now Pia's products.
You know what I swear by, though? Everybody's like, how do you stay so dark? But I really, I'm pretty olive toned.
Right, right.
And my mom's pretty dark, too, but I use Jergens Natural Glow.
That,
I'm telling you, all the girls on tour are using it now. It works amazing.
If you know, there are certain things that are worth buying expensive and some that are fine to go to CVS.
Right.
What are the ones that are worth the spending the money and some that are you could totally get that from CVS?
Well, I'm the worst because... this is such a bad habit, but I feel like if it's more expensive, it works better. I'm not good with that question. I'll go to Duane Reade and spend $300 on
Duane
lotion.
Greed, that's not hard to do.
When it comes to mascara, are you all for you have to buy it at Clinique or you have to buy, you could do CVS?
Because they
CoverGirl.
Have CoverGirl and Liz L'Oreal and Maybelline and all that stuff, and I have it all. You have to see my makeup bag. That's why my suitcase weighs 98 pounds.
Oh, wow.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, let me ask you this. When you were on American Idol, when they sat down to do your makeup, was there something you were ever I'll just do it? Because sometimes I'm like that when I'm getting my makeup done. I'm like, just, I'll just
You have
my
beautiful
lipstick.
Skin. You're,
well,
you have
thanks.
Gorgeous skin. You're stunning. But I'm the pickiest when it comes to makeup. Luckily, the makeup artists on American Idol were amazing. So they were really good. And I really never had any, complaints or issues.
Good. Because sometimes I've
gotten better. I've gotten better, I have to say. Because I know from doing other people's makeup, and they're always like, can you just do that? Make the crease a little darker and this and that. And I'm like, just sit down. I'll do the job. But I've gotten a lot better with that. So.
Do you do your makeup for the tour?
I go in, we have a wonderful makeup artist on tour as well, Monica.
Oh, okay.
She's amazing. But sometimes we only have 20 minutes in the chair.
Wow.
Everything's really quick. So I try to go in, like I said, with just a foundation, and she does my eyes and, finishes the rest, and she's amazing.
I love talking about makeup.
This is fun. I could talk all day.
What about you have perfect eyebrows?
I just got them threaded yesterday. Thank God.
Threaded.
My eyebrows will go back the same week I get them done. So I need to get.
Yeah. Gotta maintain.
Yeah. Well,
is threading your option of choice? Because I've always been nervous about the thread. I've never done it.
Honestly, it hurts. Like, I can sit through a tattoo and not flinch, but I can't get my eyebrows without flinching.
Really?
Yeah. But I used to wax and then thread, but now I just thread. I think it comes out better, and I need it to last longer.
Well, I think it makes sense with the pain now that you say it, because you always see it in the window in Manhattan, the eyebrow threading, but it's always just the eye.
Yeah.
You never see the person going,
I know.
So I guess that's why they focus on the eye if it's painful. I never knew that.
Yesterday I got yelled at because she was like, can you not do that? Because I'm going to mess up. And I'm like, I'm sorry. It hurts.
It hurts.
Still let me hurt you.
I know.
It'll be pretty.
Well, I'm so glad we got to talk to you today. I know we have a limited time, but it's so much fun and we're so happy for you.
Oh, thank you so much.
And we're glad you're home at the Napa
Health. I'm happy to be home.
Yes. Well, congratulations on everything.
Thank
you. We love the new single and we can't wait to hear the full album in November.
Thank you so much.